वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वांशाकल्पतरुवश्य कृपासिन्धुवश पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे परमानन्दमाधवं वृंदावै तुलसीदेवै पियावै केशवस्य कृष्णभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्तो भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्भरुण धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नम् अविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पुनतपाल भवाद्दीपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गपवधू स्वदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभुनित्यानन्द स्याद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद स्याद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाबुदातो संकीर्तनैकपितरो कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत प्रिय करो करुणा भतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानाम् गंगा तरंग रमणीय जटा कलापम गौरी निरंतर विभूषी त्वाम भागम नारायणो प्रियमनंग मदापहारम वाराणसीपुरपति भजभीषनाथम वागीशजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare, Hare. Nikhilo bhuvana maya chinna vichinna karti, Vibhudo bahulo megyam mukti mahanta datri, Shithilito vidhiragaradhuradhe shadhani, Bilashatu hedanityam bhakti siddhanta bani, Nikhila bhavano maya chinna vichinna karti, Vibhudo bahulo megyam mukti mahanta datri, Shithilito vidhiragaradhuradhe shadhani, Bilashatu hedanityam Bhakti Siddhanta Mani. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to collect things which is not related to Krishna Bhajan is the main disease of those bonded souls. To collect things which has no connection with Hari Bhajan, this is the main disease of bonded soul, to collect. To collect things not related to Krishna Bhajan is the main disease of bonded soul. Because bonded souls, they are in Maya. Prakriti kya manani guna karmair havasa. This sloka you know. Prakriti kriya manani. Actually, everything done by Prakriti, but they think Prakriti kriya manani gunair karmani sarvasaha. Ahankara vimuratta karta aham iti mannati. They are actually controlled by the three modes of nature, prakriti, according to their previous sanskar. Their previous sanskar can drive them. It's one kind of, you know, driving force. So, they cannot come out of maya. It's not possible. So anyway, I was discussing some point about see Daiva Varnasram Dharma, how according to previous sanskar, people can develop present sanskar. Also in present life, if they are going to do something, then plus minus can be there. And the residue going to, and the rest, final sanskar at present going to follow them in the next life. This way, birth after birth, their karan sarir. Karan sarir mean is a fine sarir there, gross body, after that fine body. Fine body is made up man, buddhi, chitto, ahankar. I was speaking about this point long time ago. So, man, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, those are four fine body. According to that, jivatma can go from one body to another, one body, this body can live and go, enter into another body. According to previous sanskar, how, but like the smell, good smell of, you know, flower, when we can see, that there is a garden, nice garden, and from there, nice smell of nice flower coming to give us indication that there is garden, there is nice flower. This way, like a nice smell is, you know, is always taken by air. This way they can go from this body to another body. So, anyway, they have no way to change their mood. Anyway, they have no way out. There is only one and single way out, that is called Bhagavad Bhajan. Because through Bhagavad Bhajan, I can prove you, one Rajatama Bhakti also can change gradually and ultimately can reach the final level of Hari Bhajan, actual Hari Bhajan. So, I can show you gradually that it is possible only through Hari Bhajan. The same slok I was speaking 2 days ago, that by the power of Sadguru, everything is possible. What is not possible for Sadguru? What is not possible by Sadguru? Everything is possible. Sadguru means Vaishnav Sadguru. Sadguru, this term is only scientific and applicable in case of Shuddha Vaishnava. So everything is possible. Pangung langhete grim. We can speak, but we cannot believe. That is the main problem. Pangung langhete grim. And Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur requesting in front of Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, you arrange the situation in such a way so that I can increase, I can go on increasing my belief in Guru Vaishnava every fraction of second. Vaishnava Vishas Vidhi Hod Khane Khane. This is actually Siddhi. To criticize Guru Vaishnava, and criticize, you know, a spiritual nice organization, you know, it's not, you know, Vaishnava. So, Vaishnava Vishwas Vidhi Hog Khane Khane. Every fraction of second, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I am praying unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so that every fraction of second I can increase my belief, strong belief in Guru Vaishnava. Vishwas Shabde Kahe Shuddhira Nishchaye. Vishwas, this word itself is meaning we can get in Chaitanya Charitamrita. The Vishwas Shabde Kahe Shuddhira Nishchaye. Vishwas means strong faith in scripture, in the, you know, in the instruction of Guru Vaishnava. It is called, and Krishna Bhajan can give me everything, all solution I can get. But who is going to reach up to that point? Actually, those who are under the influence of nature, they should follow their own duty according to their nature. If they are going to break rules and regulation, then it's very big danger, not possible for them. So this way, I was speaking that very often Prabhupada used to explain this sloka, se se adhikare janishtha sa gunaha parikirtita viparyasu dosho sad uvayo resha nirnayaha. Krishna Bhagavan speaking in Srimad Bhagavatam 11th canto, 21 chapter, 2nd sloka. Sheshe Adhikari. I mean, yesterday I was discussing that to get established in respective personal right and to do accordingly, duty, is called gun. And to break these rules and regulation and to go for other duty which is not applicable in my life, it is called doshaha. Gun and dosh. This is the judgment of dosh and gun. So this system is really perfect system, scientific, though at present situation is so dirty. At present, it is really impossible to implement this theory. But if we are successful to implement this theory, then 100% we can get success. That is why yesterday I was speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking this way in one book, that actually in European country, American country, they at least going to follow the nature of any boy or girl. What is the nature? So it is one kind of partial, implementation of Varnasam Dharma. Anyway, Varnasam Dharma is not applicable there, but still they are very intelligent. At least they can follow this point from Gita. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, at least they are going to follow this point. Through this point, they can come out successful. Development, they are making development, because they are going to give chance to proper person, and for what he is fit. So this kind of application is also very good, actually. That's why we can see that they are going to, carefully they are going to watch what is the nature of the boy. From kindergarten itself, they are watching. So this way, they are watching and trying to help them. So gradually, in respective field, they have some knack in respective field. So they are going to come out successful this way. Yeah. So this way, actually, this Varnasam Dharma at present, you can think is absurd. You can think so. But then you can develop some aparat. Because you are going to express some doubt in the instruction of Krishna. Whereas you are doing the bhajan of Krishna, Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking this sloka. So, chaturvarna maya system guna karma vibhaga saha, when speaking, 100% it is perfect. It is applicable. If you can apply, a lack of our sincerity, lack of our honesty cannot allow us to follow this process. Already I told, the whole world they are going to arrange. What to speak about whole world? In India itself I am speaking. Whole ministers and their, you know, their big, big leaders, they are trying to, totally, you know, break this system. It is their duty. They like to project, they always like to project themselves. They always like to project themselves, their character. They see, we are so liberal, we are so free, we have no conservative attitude. This way, they want to project themselves. But actually not that. I already told you yesterday that that one Shudra minister, he wanted to make disturbance. But is it possible? You just think about it. Is it possible for those sweeper to enter into temple to do worship? They can pronounce any mantra? They can pronounce? How is it possible for them? They have no saucha-achar, nothing. They cannot maintain. It is not possible. Now if you say a total varnasam dharma is useless, we should not follow, we have, you know, this, you know, this system is very bad system. All human beings, all same. Yes. All human beings, all same. It is not your statement. I already told that day that previously when creation was done by Brahma, by the order of Krishna, that time there was no division of caste and creeds. There only one, Hansa. Because that time it was not necessary to segregate. But after that it was felt, you know, that we should segregate this system of the society, segregate the human beings according to their gun evang karma, scientific way, so that we can get maximum output and at least there cannot be any disturbance in the society. Now still, if you are not going to obey me, if you are ready to fight me, now suppose somebody is there who is simply busy with his a sweeping job, these are sweeping and road and a shudra there. Then if you want to engage them in puja, is it possible? Is it possible? You think about it, how it is possible? So they have their respective duty they should perform. So this way we can maintain this society in such a way so that there can be outcome, can be very good. But at present there is breakdown because nobody wants to follow this system. That's why there is big problem. Otherwise, what to do? There is big problem. Shudra going to marry Brahman. Brahman going to marry Kshatriya. You already know. So this is actually bad system. This is not inter-caste marriage. This is just not allowed. And if you say, what to do, Maharaj? He love her. This kind of love has no value. In material platform, this kind of love is one kind of dirty karma. So you can give this kind of preference, Maharaj, what to do. They grow some love affair among them. But I can say that this love affair has got no meaning. It's actually material love affair. I can also give example, Devjani and that Raja, Jajati. You can remember the case of, I am giving example from Srimad Bhagavatam itself. So when Jajati could hear one sound, please save me, please save me. Where from this sound coming? Jajati wanted to follow. And then he could realize, oh, this sound coming from a dead well. Then, Devjani shouting. Then after Devjani could see the king Jajati and requesting him, please save me, Rajan, I am fallen into this. How you are falling? My friend, I am in Sakhi, Sarmistha, throw me into, purposefully, throw me, dash me, push me into this court. Okay, please help me. Then after that, Devjani was helped by Raja Jajati, King Jajati, to get out of the well. Then after that, Jajati wanted to pass away the case, but actually Devjani started crying. I cannot leave your hand. Well, why? Well, it is a system in Shastra. If you are going to catch my hand, you will have to marry me. No, I cannot marry you. No, you will have to marry. There is a system. In Sanskrit, we say, Pani Piran. We say Pani Piran. Pani Piran means to catch the hand lovefully. A one, you know. This is called actually the system in Rig Veda, and Samveda, I mean a mantra, you know, about marriage according to, you know, Vedic system. So Jajati was thinking, actually, you are actually Brahmin, I am actually Kshatriya. It's not possible. But yes, possible, you will have to. Anyway, I was already cursed by, by Koch, that I cannot get married with any Brahman. So anyway, I am bound to marry you. This way, this kind of marriage was approved somehow. But this kind of marriage is not approved. But what to do? It was actually this kind of marriage was approved somehow. This way, one by one, so many examples I can show you that this kind of marriage, though not possible, but this kind of marriage was there. You can remember Shakuntala and Raja Dushyanta Raja. Dushyanta Raja and Shakuntala. So, actually, Dushyanta Raja was not interested to marry Shakuntala. But somehow, when Dushyanta Raja came, the father of Bharat Maharaj, King Raja Bharat, big. So, that time actually, when he came in forest for hunting, that time Kannamuni was not there in that ashram. Kannamuni went somewhere. In the meanwhile, the Shakuntala was there. But anyway, when after hunting period is over, then darkness coming, so somewhere to take rest. They find one very nice ashram there. They searching for some place where to take rest. Then finally, they reach the ashram and asking if there is any manurisis. Then Shakuntala coming out and politely speaking in front of king, who you are? I am actually Raja Dushyanta. Where is Muni? Muni has gone for some seva. Maybe he cannot come today. So, could you please arrange our resting here in this ashram? Well, why not? Please, you stay. Ashatam jadi rochate. Rochate means if you like, you can stay here. Very well. After that, everything was done. What is necessary for a host to do for a guest, all done. But at the night time, actually Dushyanta Raja feeling attraction for Shakuntala. Shakuntala also feeling attraction. Somehow that Raja Dushyanta was bound to marry Shakuntala by some procedure is there. One procedure, Rakshas marriage, Rakshas, Udvaha. Marriage is different kind of marriage is there, prescribed. It is not normal marriage procedure somehow. So Gandharva Vivaha marriage, like Krishna and Radharani, bound to marry each other there in Bandirvat. But this is not important for us because we are interested in Raganuga Bhajan. That time, Raja Dushyanta, when going to get the association of Shakuntala, Shakuntala was interested. After that, Raja Dushyanta going to pass one remark. What is your actual identity? Could you please speak? Then Karna Muni speaking. That Shakuntala speaking. I am the daughter of that and that. Then Dushyanta Raja speaking. Well, we are in the pure destiny. This kind of illegal activities we cannot do. So I was thinking for a long time, why I am feeling attraction for you? Actually, now it's okay, it's matching. So you are also Kshatriya, I also Kshatriya. This way I can give one by one example. This kind of marriage was possible that time. So also, I can go to Srimad Bhagavad Mahapuran to give you one example. One by one example I can give you. So, Sutadev Goswami is speaking Harikatha in front of Sanakadi Rishi. That time Sutadev Goswami himself going to declare Vayam Bilomu Yataha. Bilomu Yataha. Bilomu Yataha. Anulom Bilom. You are doing Krishna Bhajan, na? You should have clear idea about you. Otherwise, some people can misinform you. You can misunderstand me. You can become angry. You can fight with me. This chapter, this topic is so sensitive, that nobody like to touch this chapter. If somebody cannot explain by the blessing of Guru Bharga, then there is big fighting can take place. So, it's very sensitive issue. So, I like to take your time to explain this in such a way so that you cannot have any complaint against me. Because believe me or not, I am sitting in Vyasasan. I have no enmity with anybody. I have no sectarian attitude. You can see some political leader, they are going to approach you in a very tricky way. They're speaking, we are actually within no party. And Bengali and Sanskrit is a Nirdolio. Nirdol means party. We are actually Nirdolio. We are not attached with any party. But Prabhupada speaking, you are not in any party. It is also one kind of party. I am not attached with any party. I am actually neutral party. It is also one kind of party. You are not at all neutral. You want to project yourself as neutral. But actually, I can prove 100% that you are not neutral. You are going to project one team, one party, to show your capacity, your power. So this is also illegal, actually. So I have no enmity. I have no party color. I have nothing, no jealousy. You can test me. But when I am going to speak Harikatha by your order, by the blessings of all Guru Vaishnava, those who are hearing me, I am speaking because they are blessing me to speak. Like Sutadev Goswami is speaking. Sutadev Goswami is speaking in front of them, Harikatha. So, Sutadev Goswami speaking in front of, those Rishi Muni, Bayam Bilom Yataha. There is Bilom and Anulom, these two systems. Binom Arulon me is not approved actually. But if it is done, what to do? Jagannath Leela, if I can go back long history, that Vidyapati one Brahman long ago, I am not speaking today, that Vidyapati was bound to marry Doita Panda. Now at present you say two categories of Panda you can find. Dvaita Panda, they have their right to serve Krishna, Jagannath, at the time when Brahman, at the time when Jagannath going to take rest, I mean, not giving darshan. At that time, up to Rathalala, Rathayatra end, they have their right to do seva. It is one special case. It is one special case. They are actually, you know, getting right by the order of Jagannath himself. So it is one special case. We cannot break this system. So, Vidyapati is a big, big Brahman. Vidyapati was bound to marry daughter of that leader who was doing seva of Jagannath secretly at the bank of Mahanadi. You know what I mean to say, you surely you know, that Jagannath, first appearance of Jagannath there in Shatajugadit. This way There actually, that Dvaitapati, he used to serve Jagannath secretly, but ultimately, Vidyapati was ordered by king to get the information why Prabhu appeared. We cannot know, some secret seva is going on, we don't know. So let us take information. After that, when Vidyapati reaching the right place, then he was giving place in the room, in the house of Dvaitapati, Dvaitapati, the daughter of that, you know, Dvaitapati, she was interested to marry Vidyapati, and Vidyapati also thinking, if we can marry, can get some extra advantage, we can discover Jagannath. So this way, at the how to go, because anyway he is not going to take. Anyway, when the marriage was done, then that girl and that lady, that a daughter of the Dvaitapati giving information, I can give you some mustard seed in your hand. So when my father going to take you like a blind man with all cloth, heavy cloth on eyes, so that you cannot detect the way where Jagannath is. So this way, the daughter giving idea, I can give you some mustard seeds. Anyway, that rainy season coming, so you can go and throwing the seeds that can grow, then you can detect the total track way after that. So this way actually, you can reach up to that place. So this way Vidyapati was successful to reach, but by the order of Jagannath, Actually, Vidyapati married two girls. One is from daughter of that Dvaitapati. Another is Brahmin girl. So those are taking birth parampara. They are serving in Jagannath temple all the time, and those who are taking birth from this branch, they are also getting seva according to the instruction of Jagannath. So this is also one kind of marriage, but this marriage is usually not approved. This can make some system of the society can break down. So this way we can know that Sutadeva Goswami is speaking that Vayam Bilom Yataha. Vayam Bilom Yataha. Bilom Anulom mean Bilom and Anulom. Bilom mean a Brahman husband and Kshatriya wife. Then, and the just opposite, Kshatriya and Swami husband and Brahman, This way just opposite. These are anulom and vilom. This system is not approved actually in Shastra. Has some scientific reason. I can give. Otherwise you can misunderstand me. So I will have to give judgment one by one so that you have no scope to misunderstand me. Now first of all, I like to put one question in front of you. Suppose you are a small boy. Just you are going to start your educational life. You are a small boy of 4 years, maybe 3 years or 4 years. Now it is a system in Vedic society. When you are going to start your education, you will have to approach a nice Pandit, Brahman, who can help you, who can catch your hand and help you to write A, B or O, A, K, K. It is a system. In our childhood also, this system was, you know, that time it was, you know, that time it was a system. So some Brahman Pandit can come and help me catch my hand. I don't know how to write, what is O, what is A, I don't know. He can catch my hand in front of Saraswati, Bhag Devi and help me. Oh, you write my son in a big slate and one writer writing, you know, some writing stone. So you can, in Sanskrit we say Kachini, in Bengali we say chalk, in English we say chalk. So he can help me to write
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Sheshe Adhikari Janishtha, Saguna Parikirtitah, Viparyastu Doshah, Shad Uvayo Resha Niranayah.
I was speaking about Nilmadhav. I was speaking about Nilmadhav before Jagannath manifest. Nilmadhav is also Jagannath, already appeared there at the bank of, you know, Mahanadi. So that time, actually, Daitapati was bound to give marriage. So this way, those, you know, parampara coming, those who are taking birth from that girl, they are actually, they have their right to do seva in special case. And those Brahman and Vidyapati, he had one Brahman and wife from there. Their parampara going on this way, they are going to do seva parampara. This is a system set by Jagannath. Usually it is not applicable, it is not approved. So anuloma viloma you are speaking. Brahman husband and kshatriya wife, anulom vilom, just opposite. I mean Brahman, wife and husband kshatriya. So this kind of, you know, intercaste marriage, you can think it over and again. Why I can also speak that how Parikshit, actually Yudhishthira Maharaj asking some question. Yudhishthira Maharaj asking some question in front of Nahush Raj. Nahush, you can remember, who was cursed by Agastya Muni to become python. So is actually giving curse. So also Bhrigu Muni in Mahabharata Salla Parva, there also I was bound to speak, Na Visheshasti Varnanam Sarvam Brahma Vidam Jagat. So Na Visheshasti Varnanam Sarvam Brahma Vidam Jagat Brahmana Purva Sishtam Hi Karma Vir Varnatam Gatam. How they got segregation gradually, but at first there was no segregation. Because that time there was no segregation. Why? Because all same one caste was there. That is called, they are actually, Hamsa. So, there was a system. So, Adau Krita Yuge Varno Nenam Hamsa Iti Sritaha
कृतकित्वा प्रजा याता तस्माद् कृतयुगम विदुहु तेतायुगे महाभागो प्राणानो मे हृदयात्रयी विद्या प्रादुर्भूत तस्या अहम आस त्रिविद मखः. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन डिटेल, नॉट पॉसिबल. अच्छा, एक्चुअली युधिष्ठिर महाराज आस्किंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ नहुष राजा देन महाभारत महाभारत वन पर्व दैट एक्चुअली युधिष्ठिर महाराज आस्किंग हाउ वी कैन गेट सेग्रीगेशन इन द सोसाइटी बिकॉज ऑल द सिस्टम इज सेम. एनी मैन कैन गिव बर्थ टू एनी चिल्ड्रन इन एनी वाइफ, सो दिस वे हाउ वी कैन सेग्रीगेट. दैट्स वाई इट्स रियली इम्पॉसिबल बट स्टिल पॉसिबल बिकॉज क्रिस्टो स्पीकिंग साइंटिफिक प्रोसीड्योर. सो नहुष राजा स्पीकिंग टू युधिष्ठिर एक्चुअली सर्वपुरी एक्चुअली युधिष्ठिर महाराज स्पीकिंग टू नहुष राजा, नॉट दैट नहुष राजा स्पीकिंग. नहुष राजा बॉन्डेड कंडीशन, नहुष राजा फॉल डाउन बिकॉज ही डन सम मिस्टेक अन टू दम अपराध अन टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ सची देवी, आई मीन द वाइफ ऑफ इंद्रराज. सो he is actually fallen, so she fall down by the cards of Agastya Muni in the form of snake, python. So Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking in front of Nahush, when Nahush Maharaj asking how we can segregate this shokra vichar according to shokra vichar, I mean the according to shokra vichar mani in a genetical parampara, how is possible? Then Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking, actually see, if we are not going to follow scientific system, then it is not possible to trace out. It is not possible to trace out the origin of the system because any man can give birth to any give birth in the womb of any woman, any baby can take birth. And the so this way this system, maybe Brahman can give birth to Shudra lady, a Shudra man can give birth to Brahman lady. This way there is as such there is no. If you want to break this regulation, then we have nothing to do at all. If you can understand the scientific procedure, then you can follow this system and you can get the ultimate result is very good. So this way not possible. So also at present in Kalikal especially you cannot find that where is Vaishya, where is Sudra, all mixed up at present, or very difficult to understand because you cannot find, nobody going to follow pure rules and regulation to establish genetical factor purely. No, they are not ready to maintain genetical factor. So also in Kalikal they are they are speaking we are Brahman, but they are actually Rakshas. Rakshasaha kalimasritto jayante brahmajanishu utpanya brahmakule badhante kshatriyano krishano. Actually those were demonic character asura and rakshasa. They are going to take birth in Kalikal in Brahman race. They want to prove we are actually Brahman. They are going to put some operation on common people, this that, in the name of religion. But the system I want to mean is not operation. The system is scientific. Bhagavan Sri Krishna wanted to mean that if you can follow this system, you can get result. But nobody want to do it. They want to prove that we are more liberal. We have no sectarian attitude. But not that. Actually some people can fight that we are actually some acharya brahman, he is not actually some acharya vaishnava, he is not bound to take prasadam in the same row, because at the time of Mahaprabhu you can see, you can go, Mahaprabhu never wanted to break the system. There was system, seniority must be given priority, it is our general formula in this society. But who is senior, who is not, who is doing bhajan? So at the time of Mahaprabhu, nobody can sit according to their own wish. When they are going to take prasadam, they will have to maintain row. This row for these devotees, that row for that devotees. And Haridas Adi, and they, actually Surup Sanatan, they are going to maintain exclusive rules and regulations. We are actually fallen soul. We have no right to take prasadam in the same row. We can take after. This way, actually the whole system is very scientific. Mahaprabhu never wanted to break this system. So, in Kalikal, actually, those Rakshas, those demonic character, they want to break the whole system. They want to prove, we are actually Brahman. You see, we have a skirt tet. But what Prabhupada wanted to do, Prabhupada wanted to give a reminder. Prabhupada wanted to give a reminder all the time. See, you have taken skirt tet. You will have to go up to this limit of Brahmanism. If you can reach up to this point, and then through Sravan, Kirtan and Sadhasanga, automatically you can go up. From Sudra level also you can go up to Brahman level. So Haridas Thakur is more than crores of Brahman. That I know. You already hear from me Harikatha. Advaita Gosai wanted to speak that when you are going to take Shraddha pot plate, then I am going to serve crores of Brahman. Tumi khaile, if you are going to take this plate, Shraddha plate, then I am going to get the result of crores of Brahman. So we know 100%. But still, Haridas Thakur never wanted to break this rule system. Advaita Gosai also never wanted to break the rule system. That was a So Advaita Gosai usually used to send prasadam to Fulia, I mean to Haridas Thakur daily. In this big festival there also, Shraddha, that time Advaita Gosai, who is Mahavishnu himself, he is speaking. When Haridas Thakur is speaking, it is not good in front of those Brahman. It's actually you should not give this prasadam plate to me. I have no right to take it. But Advaita Gosai speaking, Sei Achiripo Jei Shastra Mate Kahai. What is there approved in Shastra, be sure. What is there approved in Shastra, be sure. I am going to follow the same procedure. Don't afraid. You will have to take this plate. If you take this plate, then I am going to get the result of crores of Brahman. If taking prasadam, I can get result when you are going to take prasadam. Because I cannot speak that Haridas Thakur is equal to 2 crores of Brahman. I mean, what I mean to say, infinity Brahman, if I can put one side, Karmakarni Brahman, and if I put Haridas Thakur one side, I can run to the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur. I can ignore them. There is a system. So what I mean to say, what Krishna wanted to do, what Prabhupada wanted to implement, is not to disturb the whole system. At the same time, those devotees, they coming through their skirts, said, Prabhupada wanted to remind them, come on man, be careful. At least you will have to go up to this Brahman level. I am not going to give you a chance to become a hooligan. I am not going to make you a gangster. But you are going to, change your life. After being a spiritual leader, you have to threat. Why you are going there to hear Harikatha? Harikatha is open to all. Harikatha means Vaikuntha Katha. Why this kind of restriction you are going to put like Kamsa? You are going to get the, ultimately you are going to get the punishment like Kamsa. Why you are going to? Harikatha is live. Harikatha is open to all. If at all, if it is Harikatha, I have no political game. I have no intention to fight with somebody. So if somebody is going to hear Harikatha, what wrong in it? If you like to hear my Siddhanta, I like to cut relation with my previous guru. If he is going to speak that way. It is a system set in Shastra, but I am not going to give you this kind of advice. This can make the system more dirty. So I am not going to. So you will have to follow Bhagavad Katha secretly. Go on, So I already told that day, long ago, that actually, when actually Pitama Vishwa, in front of Pitama Vishwa, Gurudev, I mean that, Parshuram speaking, hey, we have to do this. He said, come on, you are giving this order? I am actually, from birth, I am maintaining Brahmacharya. You are giving order to marry Ambika, Ambalika. How I can marry? It's not possible. Now you will have to marry. I can leave you. Kajja kajjo mayanato utpatapatipannasso parityaga vidhiyate. If Guru going to guide me wrongly, totally opposite way, that I am bound to leave my Guru. I am bound to leave my father, mother, who else? Whoever else. Is a system of Shastra. I don't know what procedure you like to follow. But I don't like to misguide you. Don't go for fighting. Simply, you can go on hearing Harikatha. You can get bumper success power. If at all I am not a cheater, then you can get success 100%. I can promise you. Because I have no intention to fight with anybody. So, you see, so those who are Rakshas, Rakshasaha kalimasritto jayante brahma janisu utpanya brahmana kule vyadhante sotriyano krishano. Now they are going to take birth in Brahman family. They wanted to prove, hey, we are from Brahman family. But they are actually going to disturb the whole system. In the name of Brahmanism, they are not at all Brahman. They are not at all Sudra. So already I give you a one by one document. That how I can say Haridas Thakur is more and more than crores of Brahman. So I know. But Haridas Thakur not going to break the social system. Because the whole society there in ignorance. In front of ignorant people, if you are going to follow this kind of rule, they can get indulged. Well, what is the wrong it? We can break whole system. So, I can go to Gita also to discuss some procedure. So, how Krishna never wanted to break this system. So, when Arjuna started speaking in Gita, that actually when the total system is breakdown, when I am going to, you know, total system going to break down, then big problem. So, also Krishna Bhagavan speaking, Shankaro narakayoivo kulagnanam kulasacha patanti pitaroihi esham lupta pindo dako kriyaha Shankara hybriding. I mean intercaste marriage and whole system now breakdown. Anybody can marry anybody. They are running their life fancifully. This way whole system now almost breakdown. So, Shankaro narakayoivo. Even hybrids, in hybrids of flowers and fruits, I cannot approve. Because it is not approved in Shastra. Big, big manana, big, 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 double side, triple side. I am not going to take, I can throw everything. So I like to follow, and there is what is written in Gita. Shankaro narakayo iva kulagnanam kulasacha. So the total system can break down. So, total system can break down, so I cannot allow you to follow this system. So, Kulakshaya, when the total, destiny, I mean, parampara going to break down, in that case, there is mismanagement in society. So, Shankaro naraka yoibo kulagnanam kulasacha patantahi patanti pitorohi esham. Pitorohi esham. So, patanti pitorohi esham lupto pindodoko kriyaha. Actually, point is there that this kind of hybrid through this bat system and Shankara, this way the total family tradition, I mean, genetical factor can break down. And and ultimately those who are already dead, they are expecting some funeral cake from us. then they cannot get, because the total system is breakdown, genetical factors. So, promiscuity demands the destroyers of the race as well as the race itself. Deprived of offering of rice and water, I mean funeral cake, Shraddha Tarpan, the men of their race also fall down, actually. This way, so, Sankaro Narakayoiva Kulognanam Kulasacha Patanti Pitorohi Esham Lupto Pindodoko Kriya. Krishna Bhagavan also, you know, here you can say that this system is not, you know, good. So, this way, one by one, we can give example that Kulokshaye Pranasanti Kulodharma Sanatanaha Dharme Naste Kulam Krishnam Adharmo Abhibhavati Uto. This way, actually, total system can break down. So, you will have to follow Kulokshaye Pranasanti Kulodharma Sanatanaha Dharme Naste Kulam Krishnam, actually, Krishnam Adharmo Abhibhavati Uto. So, age long family traditions. So age long family tradition disappear with the destruction of the family, you know, race, and vice having been lost, virtue having been lost, vice takes hold of the entire race. This way, all the way we can find there is big problem if you are not going to follow the Varnasam system, then ultimately we are going to get feedback. Very, very bad result we can get. So from Gita I can give so much example, but time cannot permit. So I can again go back to, say, Srimad Bhagavad Mahapuran. Also, I already told that this actually Sutadev Goswami speaking, Bayam Bilom Yataha. But there actually one thing is written in Srimad Bhagavatam, you can find that Shanukadi Rishi speaking, you are the disciple of Sukadev Goswami, because he heard from Sutadev Goswami. So actually, great elevated devotee. Though externally you can find he is not Brahman. Prabhupada giving in his commentary, Prabhupada giving writing, that in Sutadev Goswami, there is no shortage of Brahmanism. In Sutadev Goswami, there is no shortage of Brahmanism. At the same time, Sutadev Goswami going to catch Bhagavad Dharma, following Bhagavad Dharma. So he is topmost Vaishnava also. So Prabhupada wanted to speak. I can give so many examples, but time cannot. I can give, but time cannot permit. So Sutadev Goswami, actually more than Brahman, externally not Brahman, is totally established in Bhagavad Dharma. And that's why Sanakadi Rishi also never wanted to break the total system. So Sanakadi Rishi, actually, it is written in Bhagavatam, Sri Shudra Dijabandhunam Traina Gocharaha Karmas Sreyasi Muranam Sreyaha Evam Bhavetiyo Iti Bharatam Bharato Makshanam Kripaya Munina Kritam. It is written, Vyasa Goswami was thinking for a long time, why I am not getting satisfaction? What can be the actual reason? Then when Vyasa Goswami thinking over and again, Vyasa Goswami, Shaktavis Avatar of Bhagavan speaking, actually Stri Shudra, those who are Stri, women, and Shudra, Dijabandhu mean those who are Brahman, but fallen Brahman, like Ashwatthama, fallen. So they are called Dijabandhu. We cannot misbehave with them. They are Brahman, but due to their activities, they are not actually Brahman, Dijabandhu. Dijabandhunam, they fall down. And Sri Shudra Dijabandhunam, Troi, Troi, no Suti Gocharaha. Troi mana Ved, Ved, Riksam Yudhu Atharva, this Troi Veda, they have no right to go through Veda, Suti, Suti Gocharaha. They have no right to hear, touch Veda, hear Veda. That is the system in Bhagavatam. Whereas Mahaprabhu speaking, Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Pima Pumarthamahana. So Bhagavadji Mahaprabhu is topmost evidence. You should not express any doubt. There it is written that Sri Shudra Dijabandhunam Troyi No Surti Gochara. Vyasa Goswami is thinking, well, I have written so many things, Ved, Puran, Upanishad, everything. But they have no right to go through Ved, Vedanta. What to do? So, also they have no right to perform Jagya. Jagya also Shudra. If some Shudra going to perform Jagya, that Jagya is useless. Useless. In that Jagya, no demigods going to take anything, share, nothing. If Shudra going to do and touch Shalagram, is very bad. So, it is not approved. In Vajra Shuchika Upanishad, in Vajra Shuchika Upanishad it is written, if some Shudra, if some Pasandi, heartless people going to touch Shalagram, Shalagram speaking, if some Pasanda, if some Shudra going to touch me, then I feel that with knife is going to cut me with knife, you know, stabbing me, he is going to stab me with knife. So this is the feeling of Shalagram. So those were actually initiated by actual Gurudev. Those were actually initiated. Actually initiated means the initiation procedure should be perfect. And the Guru from whom you are going to take Diksha should be perfect, Sadguru. Then maybe some shortage is there, that but your sincerity, 100% sincerity, as a compensating factor. There can be so many shortage in your life. But yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai, tomara koruna sar. So, by the mercy of Gurudev, you can get everything, but provided you are saranagati 100%, then problem. So, Guru Kipa, He Kevalam, by Guru Vaishnava Kipa, we can get yogyata. We can get all yogyata quality. So, Sikhai Saranagati Bhaktero Pran, only Saranagati should be perfect. There should not be any duplicity. Then gradually you go on hearing Harikatha from that Sadguru and Vaishnava. Surely you can attain Brahman stage first. After crossing Brahman stage, automatically you go on hearing Harikatha. You can enjoy, you can get entry into Bhagavad Katha Tattva Vigyan. And when you are established in Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyanam Mukta Sangasya Pariyayate. This is the Siddhanta of Srimad Bhagavati Mahapra. So automatically, it's an automatic factor. So through Bhagavad Dharma, it is possible to change your heart. Though you are Shudra, I can change your life. But you should not break the social system. You can change. Paramatthik Brahmanatva you attain. What to speak about Paramatthik Brahmanatva? You can go to up to Vaishnava, this level of pure Vaishnavism. That is different. But like Haridas Thakur, like Sanatan, like Rup, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we cannot allow to break this system. Total say, hey, automatically the social people, they are so idiot. So they never like to follow any rules and regulations. If they are going to get free indulgence, they can do whatever they like demon. They are doing. Another example I can give you, why we can allow Sri Shudra to touch Gita, to touch, you know, Veda, Purana, Veda, Upanishada, we cannot, Vedanta, they cannot touch. You can fight with me. But first point is that, as per their genetical factor, if they are Shudra, they have no right. But Sutadeva Goswami, you see, Bilomo Yata is going to read Srimad Bhagavatam, which is more excellent, more and more excellent. more and more excellent than Gita, then actually Veda and Upanishada and Vedanta, more than that. But still Shukadeva Goswami is allowed to speak. That's why it is written there that this way they are actually Vyasadeva Goswami speaking. Also, if I can give another example, you can understand why Maharaj, we are not allowed to, don't fight. If you are humble enough, if you are going to accept the system approved by Supreme Lord, I think it's good for you. I can give scientific documents day by day. I can give you one example. Actually, suppose you are a hooligan, great hooligan, gangster. If I give you one sharp knife, then you can go and stab people. But if the same knife is there with one big doctor, he is not going to misuse it. That knife, through this knife, is going to use same knife, but for operation, to give relief to one patient. This way, we should not fight. So one example I was about to give, but I forget because so long this due to interruption in Harikatha. Suppose it was the system. Suppose you are going to get entry in educational field. I already told on those days in our childhood. Also, it was the system. Some Brahman Vaishnav can come, and Pandit can come and help me to write first letter. Alphabet, ka, ga, this. After that, I can go on practicing, but at that time, then actually, gradually, I can get entry into school. After that, I can get entry into college. After that, I can get entry to university. I can complete, I can become a big learned man. I can get service or anything I can do. But suppose at the time of that first writing, you are being helped by one Brahman Pandit. At that time, if you go on fighting with that Pandit and Brahman, no, I am not ready to accept this is awe. Who told you this is awe? Who told this is ka? I am not ready to accept. Then you cannot get entry into educational field. Please, please try to accept this point. If you are going to take the help of argument, I already told, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. You cannot come out successful. Unnecessarily, you can go on fighting on this point. So, somebody has to accept this procedure. Somebody has to accept this procedure without argument. Okay, well, first point, this is all. Okay, I can accept. Minimum belief, this is all, this is ka, this is ga. Then after that, when you start your education, day by day, when you become a learned man, then you can realize, well, man, when I was first started my education, that time one Brahman, one Pandit came, and helped me. He helped me to write my first. But now I'm crossing university, doctorate, everything. So this way, if you want to make progress, you know, remarkable progress. If you want to make remarkable progress in your spiritual line, it is my request that please don't go for fighting. You can go on thinking that really this procedure is okay, but at the same time you must be very careful. But if some cheater going to guide you that way, then I am not responsible. I am giving all thousands of spiritual evidence, the procedure through which you can detect what is what, through which you can detect what is false and what is genuine. After that, you cannot ask that way. So this way actually, so as per Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, you find we see that those who are stri shudra diyabandhunam strayi na suti gochara karmo shreyasi muranam shreyo evam bhavid iho iti bharata makshanam kripaya munina kritam. That muni, Vyasadeva Muni was thinking over and again how to arrange a overall benefit for everybody. Those who are Shudra, those are Stri, Dijabandhu, they have no right to touch. But at present you can discover in Vrindavan everywhere, the Gayatri Mantra they are shouting in mic. In mic it's a what is secret thing? What is secret thing? But in Kalikal, so magic spell, that in Gayatri Mantra they are, you know, in mic, loudly. Going on. So this system broken up. So what I can do for that? I am speaking about the system there written in Shastra. If you have strong belief, you can follow it. If you don't believe, then you don't follow. That's up to you. It is your own privilege. You can follow me. You cannot follow me. So Stri Shudra Dijabandhana Stroina Gocharaha, they cannot go through Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, what to do. Also, they cannot perform Jagya. So, for that reason, Vyasadeva Goswami took decision to compile Mahabharata. Because through Mahabharata, all the meaning of Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, all you can find in applied form. You can find in applied form in Mahabharata. So you need not go through Veda Vedanta restriction. Even I heard from right source. Also Bhana Goswami Maharaj also write one note and one book on Veda. I mean the primary stage. There it is written, if you are going to make wrong pronunciation of Veda and Chanda, there is one rhythm, then you are going to get punishment. Be careful. That's why, you know, those who are going to take lesson in Gurukul about Veda, Vedanta, if they are at all Brahmin boys. So, according to Varna, if they are actually showing to they are going to exhibit their quality as Brahman, this is 100% perfect, then they have their right to learn Veda, Vedanta. But Veda, Sham Veda, Rig Ved, Joju Atharva, Sam Ved, have some hymns you have to sing, but with some rhythm. That's why you will have to fold your hand, express your hand, extend your hand this way all the time. This way actually. So this way actually there is some system, rules and regulation. If you are not going to follow this system, you are going to break, you know, all rhythm, pronunciation is wrong, then you can get heavy punishment. That's why in Sanskrit, the pronunciation part is very important. Very important. But in devotional field, pronunciation is not so important because out of devotion, love appear. They cannot, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, when that Brahman, Murka Brahman, where the very illiterate Brahman is reading Gita, in Ranganath Mandir, there, then Mahaprabhu watching, how ecstatic love affair is spilling. Then ultimately Mahaprabhu was bound to ask him, what kind of, you know, thing you are watching, that every time you are shedding tears and feelings of ecstatic feeling, you cannot pronounce even properly. Then that Brahman, Murkha Brahman, illiterate Brahman speaking, actually, I was ordered by my Gurudev, though I am illiterate, I cannot read properly. My Gurudev giving me instruction, you can go on reading Shuddha Bhava Shuddha. Maybe it is perfect pronunciation or wrong pronunciation. So you go on reading. This way I was instructed by Gurudev. That's why, Maharaj, I know nothing, but still by the instruction of Gurudev, I am going to follow this system. I am reading. So what you see, what you feel, but Javat Pari Mui Tabat Pau Krishna Darshan. So long as I am reading Gita, I can clearly see Krishna is standing on chariot and giving you know instruction to Arjuna. Clearly I can see. Oh really? Yes. Mahaprabhu speaking, really so. You have the right to go through Gita. Because you know the real meaning of Gita. You know. So you have the right. Why Mahaprabhu speaking? Because Gita, we can find from Mahabharata. Gita is one portion of Mahabharata. Follow what I say. So Mahaprabhu speaking, giving, you know, glorifying, you are very right. You can go on reading, you have your right this way. So we should not follow the path of argument. The path of argument can choke our spiritual progress, you know. This way we see, Vasudeva Goswami thinking over and again, after that, Vasudeva Goswami was bound to compile this Mahabharata. Eternally Mahabharata is present there. But in this world, we find this Mahabharata. So Mahabharata was, you know, kripaya, by out of mercy, Vasudeva Goswami was bound to compile this Mahabharata. So now they have the chance to go through, you know, this, you know, Mahabharata, they can hear. But it is the strict advice of Prabhupada not to go through Mahabharata. Because ultimately I am going to establish the Siddhanta of Prabhupada, so I cannot pass away. So ultimately I wanted to speak what Prabhupada wanted to speak. My personal Siddhanta is not Siddhanta. Always I want to touch the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. So I am discussing in with long area. I am discussing this point. So it is the Siddhanta Prabhupada, though you have no right to go through Vedanta Upanishad, so you can go on hearing Bhagavatam from one genuine sadhu, who is Mahabhagavat himself. So if you go through Mahabharata, there is no surety, because most of the people, they are full of doubts and suspicion, so they can find some incident, oh, that rishi doing that is very bad. So in this way, Prabhupada speaking, you need not go through Mahabharata. Better you can go through Chaitanya Bhagavat, better you can go through Chaitanya Charitamrita, or you can get the chance to hear Bhagavatam from a realized soul, sadhu, who is himself Mahabhagavatam. This way the system was very scientific, and so Prabhupada wanted to establish this system. So through Harikatha, through Haribhajan, you can cross the ultimate limit of, you know, Varnasam Dharma. We have no objection in it. But please don't try to break this system of the society. So all different examples I am giving, through which I wanted to prove that Krishna Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, maybe in the form of Krishna or Krishna Chaitanya, never they wanted to break the system. Even Ramchandra. Ramchandra is Kshatriya. Ramchandra always with polite attitude wanted to pray Dandavat and to lotus feet of Brahman, Vaishnav, elderly persons. So humble. And Ramchandra never wanted to break the system also. So this way, almost at the end of, you know, Teta Yuga, Ramchandra took birth. Actually, Ramchandra came here in this material world. So from them, it was felt urgent, necessary to establish this Varnasam Dharma. Finally, it was established totally in Dwapara Yuga's end, finally. So this way, actually, all the system is very practical. So we cannot break this system. So, one by one, I can give you example that what Prabhupada wants to speak is very important. That actually, kulokshaye pranasanti kulodharmaha sanatanaha dharme nasti kulam krishnam adharmo abhibhavati uto. Age-long family traditions disappear with the destruction of family, and virtue having been lost, vice takes hold of the entire race. And this way actually whole system can break down. So we have no right to break the whole system. So I give you example that if you fight in the beginning, then it is dangerous for you. So if you are going to accept without any argument, there's a primary things, then you can come out successful. But be careful about those who are going to misguide you. Actually, Actually, Prabhupada wanted to install this, you know, Varnasam Dharma in such a way. So externally, you can find there Prabhupada not going to disturb the whole system. Not. So also, it is written in Gita, Jasrayanu sadharmo biguno paro dharmat saunushthitat sadharme nidanam sreyo paro dharmo bhayavaha. Sreyanu sadharmo. So sreyanu sadharmo biguno paro dharmat saunushthitat sadharme nidanam sreyo paro dharmo bhayavaha. Paradharma is very dangerous. In Gita, third chapter, you can get 35 slok, that sadharma nidhanam seho. Though your sadharma, so now you are leather man. Suppose you are leather man. So leather man, you are going to follow your own duty. Shudra, you are going to follow your leather man. So you are going to follow this system. So, this way actually, but if you like to break this system, if you like to go to temple to worship, now this is the system. Who is there to pass judgment? Who is going to give particular seva to particular person? Nobody. Now only politics going on. How many red clothes? How many sannyasis in our society? Quality is less interested. Quality is not a big matter. So how much, you know, demons are there in our society? That is the main factor. We can count. Maharaj, 100 brahmacharis, 108 brahmacharis in our society. But Maharaj, if you go on testing, that's why, don't misunderstand me. I can touch the lotus feet of my Guru Maharaj. I can show you practically. They can fight. They can say, why Maharaj going to touch this point? Why not? I want to bring back the old system set by Prabhupada. That's why I want to do. I am not going to criticize. I can show you one by one that how they are going to break all rules and regulations set by Prabhupada. But they can speak, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada. Ah, who care, man? Who care, man, by your Jai Prabhupada? You are a demon, actually. You are not going to follow Prabhupada at all. And Abhirbhaptiti, okay, we can jointly, you know, you can jointly do, jointly. Eh? Eh? Jointly, you are going to fall. Foolish. Hmm? This is the system actually. So at present, everybody like to throw Prabhupada away. To be frank, everybody at present like to throw Prabhupada. Prabhupada means Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. Prabhupada. At present, everybody like to pass away Prabhupada. If they are going to follow Prabhupada, it is very tough. Nobody can follow. Be sure, for infinity period, if you are going to do bhajan without the help of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, never, for infinity period, you can do bhajan. You cannot come out successful. You cannot come out successful. You cannot come out successful. It is not possible. I heard from Guru Bhargava, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, without the implementation of achar adarsa, idealism, and in all acharan, you cannot run Gauriya Math. You can run Gauriya society, but you cannot run Gauriya Math. Not possible. Now I want to give one by one example through which you can understand this point. Don't try to misunderstand me. If you leave me alone in a forest, I was also, in that case, I need not speak even a single word with anybody. So what? I need not speak anybody. So if you are going to engage me in Harikatha, then I am acting as Sadguru. So Sadguru mele bhed batave, Tulsidas ji speaking. It is the duty of Sadguru to speak, this is wrong, this is right, so I cannot pass away. Those who have practical experience about my life, they know. Day after day, months after months, year after year, I am not going to speak anything against. anything, only Harikatha sometime, or maybe in front of one devotee, or reciting myself alone in front of Supreme Lord. That time I need not speak anything, but when you give me responsibility to show the exact way, then it is my duty. I am not going to criticize anybody. So Guru Vaishnav, sometime they feel it necessary to represent, to present comparative statement. That doesn't mean it is criticism. Tulsidas Ji Maharaj speaking, Sadguru mele bhed batave gyan kare upadesh, कैला का मैला छूटे जब आंख करे प्रवेश. कैला का मैला छूटे जब आंख करे प्रवेश. तुलसीदास जी स्पीकिंग वेरी हम्बल वेरी सिंपल वे. सदगुरु मिले. व्हेन आई मीट विथ ए सदगुरु, सदगुरु फर्स्ट वॉच मी माय हार्ट. दिस काइंड ऑफ डर्टीनेस इज देयर, देन ही कैन स्टार्ट गाइडिंग मी अकॉर्डिंगली. सो वेरी शॉर्टली आई कैन फाइंड दिव्य ज्ञान हृदय प्रकाशित and my darkness, you know, agyanati mirandasa, all darkness can disappear. Oh, very light and light all everywhere. You know, gyan means light. So, as soon as you are going to get the torch of knowledge by one Sadguru, then and there you can discover what is what, where is what. Suppose for 1,000 years, one palace is in darkness, nobody going to enter. But if one government team, archaeology department going to get so many torch hold by all their members, they're going to enter into that cave, and there then you can instantly discover where is where. Oh, there is golden coin, there is jewels. At present also in India, five, six places, all secret, hidden treasure discovered already. In Odisha also, in Jagannath Puri, now it is broken temple. It was one Ramanuja temple or Ramanindi, I forget actually. From government, it was taken over by government when they started, breaking the building, they find bricks of gold. Bricks of billions of dollars. You cannot count. So many golden brick was found. Just in front of Jagannath temple. I think. Probably you know. So this way actually, Tulsidas Ji Maharaj speaking, Sadguru mele bhed batave. What do you mean by bhed batave? Because you usually don't know Hindi. I am requesting you learn Bengali, Maharaj, learn Bengali. Learn Hindi, you are not learning. You have no time. You have time to eat, you have time to sit, you have all time. But you have no time to make progress in Hari Bhajan. Then, if I give you order, Maharaj, I am feeling sleepy. I like to take rest. This is your bhajan procedure. So how I can approve? So I cannot give illness. This way I cannot approve. So you see, Sadguru mele bhed batave itself, it means that Sadguru, it is the duty of Sadguru to show you, hey, don't go there. Don't go there. Don't go there to hear Harikatha. Is not, is very, is not sadhu, kapat. If Sadguru going to guide you that way, that doesn't mean Sadguru going to criticize somebody. Not that. Also, our Bharati Maharaj used to speak many times. It is actually a standard word, actually. I also know. But I heard from Bharati Maharaj speaking, if something is bad, really not auspicious to do, they are doing all wrong activities, Siddhanta. If some sadhu going to point out what is not false, actually is going to point out, then it is not aparad, it is not criticism. Then who can point out? Who can point out? Except Guru Vaishnava, except Guru Vaishnava, if they are going to do their solitary bhajan, Paramahansa bhajan, who can guide you? Who can show you? You can go through all shastras, you have a huge amount of money in your bank, you can go, you can buy all Vedanta, Upanishad, Puran, everything, and show me what is the net outcome. How you can understand? You can buy, but how you can realize? That's why Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, they can go to market and buy books related to Ruganuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, but where from they get realization? Where from they get realization? For realization, to get realization, direct realization, they must come in front of pure sadhu. Your billions of dollars cannot help you to get consciousness. Your billions of dollars cannot help you to get realization. Maybe your organization is big worldwide, but who can give you realization? You can fight among yourself, you can fight with each other and break down. Be careful. So, Sadguru mele ved batave gyan kare upadesh, this means it is the duty of Sadguru to show the right track. For that, if Sadguru need to speak some negative, some positive, that is not criticism. That is not criticism. So, if I am going to criticize, Rai Ramananda, oh my God, he is going to stay with all those young, you know, girls in a solitary place, then it can be one criticism. This one criticism, I can fall down. Because without any proper information, I am going to pass this karma. Pradyumna Mishra, when wanted to hear Harikatha, Mapo speaking, well, you like to hear Harikatha? Whenever I like to hear Harikatha, I go to Rai Ramananda, and sometimes Mahaprabhu go to Gadadhar Pandit. So you can go to Rai Ramananda, he is not present here, he is there in village house. So you can go, you can approach. Then when he is reaching there, he got wrong information that Rai Ramananda doing some, you know, wrong activities, you know, all illegal activities with all young Devdasis, young girls. What Rai Ramananda doing? Going to teach them Jagannath Ballabh Natak. One novel, written by him. So, is going to give them training. This way you will have to practice, speak this way, sing this way. This sentiment, this mood is, you know, Baba, you should express this way. So, to help them, this girl, to sing in front of Jagannath without any kama inside the heart, aprakita, Rai Ramananda giving training to those girl, sometime helping them to take bath, changing their clothes. So in course of this kind of seva, Rai Ramananda have the chance to look into secret organs. So what? No problem. So if sadhu is that, if it font of, you know, apsara, heavenly, those who are, you know, girls there, they devi, they are not going to feel any kama. That is called actual sadhu. So this way, sometime halfway breakdown, halfway something happen, it is not. So at present, there is no shortage of billions of dollars and prosperity. But at present, 100%, there is the shortage of guidance. Whom we can follow, whom we can believe, so that we can cross over this material world, full of misery. That is the only shortage at present. Everybody, all you can go to all marts and mandir, they are having billions of dollars, no shortage. The only shortage is there, idealism of Srila Prabhupada, not they can find in implementation. So this is the shortage at present. Whole world entering into darkness. This is the problem actually. So you see, Sadguru mele ved batave. If Sadguru, it is a duty of Sadguru to guide you properly. For that, if you need to speak some negative, some positive, therefore, that he is not going to do some aparad, nothing. So now I'm going to explain this, you know, that you know, Pradyumna Mishra, he misunderstood Rai Mahasaya. Whereas Prabhupada is Antarjami, Prabhupada could realize, oh, what is the stage of Rai Ramananda? Mahaprabhu is passing this kind of remark, only Rai Ramananda. Ek Rai Ramananda hoy oishodikar. Only Rai Ramananda having this kind of right. In front of young girls, there is no reaction. Yeah, because Rai Ramananda thinking that I am actually Sakhi. With Sakhi Manjari Bab, going to serve Radharani and Sakhi Manjari this. So 100% perfect, there is no kama inside. Luster, kama is very bad. If going to touch your heart, you can fall down from bhajan. But aprakita sadhuguru vaishnava, if you want to use your thermometer, if you want to apply your thermometer to measure the, you know, fever, temperature of one guru vaishnava, it's not possible. You will have to keep your, you know, thermometer with you. You will have to measure. Yeah. So this is not good actually. So Rai Ramananda is the only Mahaprabhu speaking, Rai Ramananda is only one. So Pradyumna Mishra was about to do great mistake, aparad. Mahaprabhu wanted to save him. Mahaprabhu is saying, you already here? No, actually, what happens? You went there? Yes, actually. What happens? Then when Mahaprabhu heard, Mahaprabhu started laughing. You go. You have committed aparad, you go. And try to hear what Rai Ramananda, I myself hearing Harikatha from him, who you are. Then that, you know, Pradyumna is again going and hearing Harikatha. This way, if you want to apply one common formula for all Guru Vaishnava, it is not good. You can make a great mistake. Great mistake. Don't try to make this. Now I want to explain this point also. What is this point actually? It is in Gita, it is written, third chapter, 35 slok, you will have to follow, then you can understand. What is written there? It is written there that Sriyanu sadharma vigunaha paradharmat sanasthitat sadharma nidhanam sriyo paradharmo bhayavaha. So, one's own duty. I was speaking about this point. If you have any specific duty according to your varna, I'm not touching ashram at present. Okay, ashram is also applicable. So you will have to lead your life according to your sanskar. If you are Shudra, if you are demon, if you are going to give some bribe to your Gurudev and taking sannyas, then we are not going to obey that you are sannyas. We'll have to follow the rules and regulation of Shastra. Tasmat Shastra Pramanante Karja Karjo Vyavasthito. What to do, what not to do. We'll have to follow Shastra. We are not going to obey you. So, I already told maybe 15 days ago, 20 days ago, in Kalikal, actually those people, they are going to take renounce order to lead their life very comfortably. So, I already told actually, 15-20 days before, that at present, some Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if the number of sannyasis and red cloth brahmacharya is going to increase, then you must think it for sure that it is one plotting arrangement of Maya, Kali. Kali going to make one big problem very shortly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you find the number of sannyasis and brahmacharya increasing day by day, not a matter of joke. Even in the whole world, it is very difficult to find one actual sannyasi. who is going to follow sannyasi by body, speech and mind. So, tasmat sasvapamananti karja karjo vyavasthita. What to do, what not to do, we'll have to follow scripture. Not that somebody can take sannyas. So, I also from Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, you know, glorification is seeing that in Kalikal, you can see somebody going to take sannyas or renounce order and they like to lead their life very peacefully, very smoothly because they are going to give donation. So actually it is strictly prohibited. Nothing is so dangerous. Nothing is so dangerous than to use this sannyas-based, renounce-based for their livelihood. They like to lead their life peacefully, very, they are going to become rich man. They are going to take the sannyas. It's very easy. We need not go and do service in the society. Oh, who is going to? It's good. If you can approach one so-called guru, I can pay something, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs. Documents I have, but I am not going to open clearly. Because you can misunderstand me. 4 lakhs. I know one man from Haridwar. He is idiot number one. Rascal number one. He wanted to approach me. Maharaj, if you can speak to my Gurudev, then he can give sannyas. I said, I cannot speak. I cannot do this. I cannot do. So he was thinking how to... Then finally he took decision to give 4 lakhs rupees to one Maharaj. Because that Maharaj is influential Maharaj. He can request, make a request in front of Acharya. Oh Maharaj, you should give this Kali Kal, you will have to do Kipa Maharaj. Then he was, when he got sannyas, then he was being really strange. It is one dirty demon. Not only demon, dirty demon, Rakshas. He is having so much case, court case, with his previous wives, 3-4 times marriage and in a breakdown, so much. How is possible for that man to take sannyas from that society? Eh? I am going to honor him as sannyasi. You think I am poor? Eh? I am going to follow the system set by Prabhupada, you see. So now, I am going to speak that Sriyano Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharmat Sanaschitat. Sriyano Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharmat Sanaschitat. That it is according to your own, own symptoms. You will have to follow your own duty and you have to perform it. If you like to break the system and like to jump, then it is a big problem for the whole world. Shudraha pratigrahi santi tapavesho upujivinaha. You can remember 20 days ago, I was explaining from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Golok glorification. Shudraha pratigrahi shanti tapavesho upujivinaha. Shudraha pratigrahi shanti tapavesho upujivinaha. And dharmam dharmam bakshanti adharmagyaha adhiruro uttamasanam. They are going to pass lecture on dharma. They are going to give a lecture on dharma. Who care man to hear your lecture? Who care man to hear? We have no time to hear lecture. Where he is giving big lecture. Thousands of idiot going to, hear it. Oh, so nice lecture, Maharaj. Yes. So they are going to follow this lecture. So dharmam bakshanti adharmagya adhiruro uttamasanam. Uttamasanam, vyasasan. That's why Jiva Goswami told, bhakta swarago nirago dibido parikirtitaha. Many times I told. So we will have to remember. Not that same Siddhanta, I can go repeatedly, I have no time. So, infinity, Sastra Siddhanta, Bhapta Siddhanta Sagaram. So here, I like to give another example, which I could not discuss fully. I left half discussion was done, about Ekalabhya. Ekalabhya is actually Shudra, low caste, very, very low caste. But somehow, it is one kind of magic, that is going to concentrate his mind in concentrated mind, in concentration of mind can give you anything. Like judo, karate, judo, kung fu. I know so many leaders, they know everything. You are sitting, if somebody coming backside to attack, immediately they can respond. How is possible? Concentration of mind. So this way is possible. But that man is really, you know, very, very low caste. He cannot use this, you know, vidya. So that actually when he is going to get this kind of vidya, but actually Dronacharya was thinking this kind of vidya, this kind of vidya is totally prohibited. He should not have, he should not get that kind of vidya. Oh my God, it is only a Kshatriya should get it. Only one actual Kshatriya who is very pious, he should get it. Otherwise big problem can happen in life. He can misuse this. Then when, you know, when Dronacharya, you know, somehow come in front of that Ekalabhya asking, where from you learn? Actually from you. From me? You never took permission from me. Well, I was worshipping your deity, concentrating, and somehow I get it. But you have not given me any Guru Dakshina. You have to, without Guru Dakshina, your vidya is useless. Well, I can, give you a Guru Dakshina. What Guru Dakshina? Whatever you have. I need your right hand thumb. Then Ekalabhya cut and give. Why? Dronacharya was not merciless. Dronacharya was very, very conscious about the future consequence. So he wanted to take away this vidya from him. Because it is not suitable. It is not as per the varnashram dharma. Not. He is actually low caste. He is going to get that kind of vidya. If he apply, then those Kshatriya, they speak problem. You can remember, I can also give answer actually. Is one kind of magic. Actually, Arjun was defeated. Arjun was defeated by some low caste, you know, Shantal Kolvil, some low tribal people at Dwaraka. From Dwaraka, when Arjun wanted to guide some wives of Krishna, then in the midway, there was a big fighting. Then Arjun couldn't stand in front of them. Actually, it is one kind of magic spell. Actually, those Shudra, they know nothing, actually Krishna. Because nobody is there who can defeat Arjun. Follow. So, anyway, Swadharme Nidhanam Seyo, it is Swadharme Nidhanam Seyo Paradharma Bhayavaha. We have so much example I can give, I can go on giving. I can go on giving from even Ramayana, Mahabharata, Upanishad, from different places I can go on. So, how Jabal Satyakam was approved by Gautami Muni. Brahmane Arjava Sakshat Shudre Anarjava Lakshanam. So, Gautami Muni could realize out of his profound knowledge and, thinking power. So, this way, this kind of discussion, to think what is what, at present we cannot get this kind of personality. It's a big problem. So, at present, now we can say all the system breakdown. So, Sreyano Sadharma Bigunaha Sadharmat Sanaschita Sadharma Nidhanam Sriyo Paradharma Bhayabha. So, now, if you engage one fisherman in salgam or sip, it's not good. But I already told, when you are going to do Hari Bhajan, suppose you are a fisherman, then no problem. If you go on and do your bhajan, and ultimately you can attain that kind of success, like we know, Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj was Kaivarta. Kaivarta means from fisherman family. So what? We can put our Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj one side, and we can put crores of Brahman one side. Actually, our Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, he was a broker of grains. Broker. So he is a Vaishya. But what to speak? You know, it's a one kind of evolution that is Brahman sister. There is no Brahman you can find, you cannot find even a single Brahman in this whole world with whom you can compare Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. He's topmost. But still Gaur Kishore Babaji are not going to break the social system. I can give argument in this favor, how you will have to follow your bhajan, at the same time you will have to be very careful about social system. So now I am going to explain this point. Next day, tomorrow, I can speak in details. So, Sriyana Sadharma, you understand a little bit. Sriyana Sadharma, my own duty is far better than the duty somebody going to do according to his own level is doing. So I cannot break this system. I cannot throw my duty and try to do that duty. It's not good. So one's own duty, though devoid of merit, one's own duty, though devoid of merit, is preferable to the duty of another people. And another well performed, though you can do it very nicely, though you are going to do that duty which is not prescribed for you, you can do it very carefully. Like the case of Ekalabba, now this kind of power coming, but this kind of power is not approved in Shastra for him. So Sriyana Sadharma, you know, his duty is to do seva of four varna ashram, whereas he is going to gather this kind of quality of a Kshatriya. It's more dangerous, nothing more dangerous than that. So one's own duty, though devoid of merit, is preferable to the duty of another person well performed. Though he can do it very nice way, but still we cannot allow him to do, because even death in the performance of one's duty brings blessing in his life. So even if you are going to follow your own duty as per your character and everything, purva sanskar, if you follow the same, what prescription is there with you, you are going to follow your sadharma. Still, if you are not come out successful by sadharma, still it is very good. But it goes in future, you are going to get some link to go ahead. But that paradharma, if you are going to follow, which is prescribed to other, with this dharma is not prescribed for you, if you are going to follow, this dharma is very dangerous for you. But still, though you can do it very nicely, perform nicely, but still, it is not good. In future, you are going to get fear. So, duty is, you are going to do, it is full of fear in your life. So, don't try to express false ego, to break rules and regulation in devotional field, try to follow what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Prabhupada wanted to speak, as per your bhajan, you can go, daiva varnasam, you can follow. Nobody going to disturb you, but please don't try to disturb the social system. Don't try to break the whole social system. So, Sriyana Sadharma Bigunaha, Padatha Paradharma Sanustitat Sadharma Nidhanam Sriyo. Even if you are going to die by following your own duty, it's still far better than you are going to throw your own duty, going to follow other dharma, which can give you, you can put you in the ocean of fear. It's very careful. It's very scientific reason there. Day by day I can go on discussing, please excuse me, time cannot permit, we have so many seva. It is not complete. I can go on discussing for another 2-3 days. So, if you can understand it, then surely I am sure that you are not going to fight with me. You are not going to misunderstand me anyway. So, from tomorrow is actually Akshaya Tritiya day. We will have to follow this day very carefully. So, right from the beginning of Harikatha, we'll have to hear. And we all devotional society, I mean, all devotees, whole all over the world, they should pray unto the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, so that peace and prosperity can come back in this world level. It's big, though it is material people can take advantage of this wrong way, still, there is big, problem going on all over the world. So it is also our duty to pray unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord for all the people, jivas, all the jiva. Though I know they are not going to do Hari Bhajan, But still, there is one big, you know, problem all over the world. So, from tomorrow, we can go on, you know, praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Like I am habituated for a long time, I am doing some Harinam. I am praying to Supreme Lord for the preservation of Gomata, so that nobody can cut. So day by day you can find, you know, we can pray unto the lotus feet of Krishna. I am not praying something for my personal benefit. I am going to pray, oh Krishna, your name is successful. I am not going to use your name wrongly. But still, I have one prayer. You can save Gomatas. If you can go and pray unto the lotus feet of Krishna, then Krishna someday can attend, someday can hear us. So this problem can go away from this whole world. So this disease, you know, all over the world going on. So maybe we can try to, hear Harikatha, attend Harikatha carefully. And after the end of Harikatha, for some days, I think, I don't know how long this problem can persist. You know, we like to recite Srimad Bhagavad-gita Mahapuran. So after Harikatha is over, I can finish. After that, maybe for 15 minutes or 20 minutes, you can go on hearing flowing Harikatha. Flowing Harikatha means only Sanskrit Srimad Bhagavad-gita Mahapuran. From tomorrow, I can try. For some period, we can try. Because we have so many seva for a long time. I don't know how far I can come out successful, but this is my desire. Vancha kalpataru sikhi pasindhi bhaccha patitanang pavane bhyo vaishnavi bhyo namo namo nikhilo bhubano maya chinna vichinna karti vibhuda bahula migyam mukti mahanta jatri shithilito vidiraga radha radesha dani Bilosatu hridi nityam bhakti siddhanta bani vancha kalpataru sikhi pasindhi bhaccha patitanang pavane vaishnavi bhyo namo namo.